Thales of Miletus, Thales, c. 624 c. 546 BC, was a pre-Socratic Greek philosopher and mathematician from Miletus in Asia Minor and one of the seven sages of Greece. Many, most notably Aristotle, regard him as the first philosopher in the Greek tradition. Aristotle reported Thales' hypothesis that the originating principle of nature and the nature of matter was a single material substance, water. Thales attempted to explain natural phenomena without reference to mythology. Almost all of the other pre-Socratic philosophers follow him in attempting to provide an explanation of ultimate substance, change, and the existence of the world without reference to mythology. In mathematics, Thales used geometry to calculate the heights of pyramids and the distance of ships from the shore. He is the first known individual to use deductive reasoning applied to geometry, by deriving four corollaries to Thales' theorem. He is the first known individual to whom a mathematical discovery has been attributed. Life. The current historical consensus is that Thales was born in the city of Miletus around the mid-620s BC. Miletus was an ancient Greek Ionian city on the western coast of Asia Minor, near the mouth of the Meander River. Background: the dates of Thales' life are not exactly known but are roughly established by a few datable events mentioned in the sources. According to Herodotus, Thales predicted the solar eclipse of May 28, 585 BC. Diogenes Laertius quotes the Chronicle of Apollodorus of Athens as saying that Thales died at the age of 78 during the 58th Olympiad and attributes his death to heat stroke while watching the games. Diogenes Laertius states that Thales' parents were Examis and Bleblin, then traces the family line back to Cadmus, a mythological Phoenician prince of Tyre. Diogenes then delivers conflicting reports. One, that Thales married and neither fathered a son or adopted his nephew of the same name. The second, that he never married, telling his mother as a young man that it was too early to marry, and as an older man that it was too late. Plutarch had earlier told this version. Solon visited Thales and asked him why he remained single. Thales answered that he did not like the idea of having to worry about children. Nevertheless, several years later, anxious for family, he adopted his nephew Cybertus. Thales involved himself in many activities, taking the role of an innovator. Some say that he left no writings, others say that he wrote on the solstice and on the equinox. Diogenes Laertius quotes two letters from Thales, one to Pherecydes of Cyrus offering to review his book on religion, and one to Solon, offering to keep him company on his sojourn from Athens. Thales identifies the Milesians as Athenian colonists. Business. Several anecdotes suggest that Thales was not solely a thinker but was also involved in business and politics. One story recounts that he bought all the olive presses in Miletus after predicting the weather and a good harvest for a particular year. In another version of the same story, Aristotle explains that Thales reserved presses ahead of time at a discount only to rent them out at a high price when demand peaked, following his predictions of a particularly good harvest. This first version of the story would constitute the first creation and use of futures, whereas the second version would be the first creation and use of options. Aristotle explains that Thales' objective in doing this was not to enrich himself but to prove to his fellow Milesians that philosophy could be useful, contrary to what they thought. Politics. Thales' political life had mainly to do with the involvement of the Ionians in the defense of Anatolia against the growing power of the Persians, who were then new to the region. A king had come to power in neighboring Lydia, Croesus, who was somewhat too aggressive for the size of his army. He had conquered most of the states of coastal Anatolia, including the cities of the Ionians. The story is told in Herodotus. The Lydians were at war with the Medes, a remnant of the first wave of Iranians in the region. Over the issue of refuge, the Lydians had given to some Scythian soldiers of fortune inimical to the Medes. The war endured for 5 years, but in the sixth an eclipse of the sun spontaneously halted a battle in progress. It seems that Thales had predicted this solar eclipse. The seven sages were most likely already in existence, as Croesus was also heavily influenced by Solon of Athens, another sage. Whether Thales was present at the battle is not known, nor are the exact terms of the prediction. But based on it, the Lydians and Medes made peace immediately, swearing a blood oath. The Medes were dependencies of the Persians under Cyrus. Croesus now sided with the Medes against the Persians and marched in the direction of Iran. He was stopped by the river Halys, then unbridged. This time he had Thales with him, perhaps by invitation. Whatever his status, the king gave the problem to him, and he got the army across by digging a diversion upstream so as to reduce the flow, making it possible to ford the river. The channels ran around both sides of the camp. The two armies engaged at Pteria in Cappadocia. As the battle was indecisive but paralyzing to both sides, Croesus marched home, dismissed his mercenaries and sent emissaries to his dependents and allies to ask them to dispatch fresh troops to Sardis. The issue became more pressing when the Persian army showed up at Sardis. Diogenes Laertius tells us that Thales gained fame as a counselor when he advised the Milesians not to engage in a symmachia, fighting together, with the Lydians. This has sometimes been interpreted as an alliance, but a ruler does not ally with his subjects. Croesus was defeated before the city of Sardis by Cyrus, who subsequently spared Miletus because it had taken no action. Cyrus was so impressed by Croesus's wisdom and his connection with the sages that he spared him and took his advice on various matters. The Ionians were now free. Herodotus says that Thales advised them to form an Ionian state, that is, a Boeotian to be located at Teos in the center of Ionia. The Ionian cities should be demoi, or districts. Miletus, however, received favorable terms from Cyrus. The others remained in an Ionian league of 12 cities, and were subjugated by the Persians. While Herodotus reported that most of his fellow Greeks believed that Thales did divert the river Halys to assist King Croesus's military endeavors, he himself finds it doubtful. Sagacity Diogenes Laertius tells us that the seven sages were created in the archonship of Damasius at Athens about 582 BC and that Thales was the first sage. The same story, however, asserts that Thales emigrated to Miletus. There is also a report that he did not become a student of nature until after his political career. Much as we would like to have a date on the seven sages, we must reject these stories and the tempting date if we are to believe that Thales was a native of Miletus, predicted the eclipse, and was with Croesus in the campaign against Cyrus. Thales received instruction from an Egyptian priest. It was fairly certain that he came from a wealthy, established family, in a class which customarily provided higher education for their children. Moreover, the ordinary citizen, unless he was a seafaring man or a merchant, could not afford the grand tour in Egypt, and did not consort with noble lawmakers such as Solon. In Diogenes Laertius's Lives of Eminent Philosophers chapter 1.39, Laertius relates the several stories of an expensive object that is to go to the most wise. In one version Bathycles of Arcadia states in his will that an expensive bowl should be given to him who had done most good by his wisdom, so it was given to Thales, went the round of all the sages, and came back to Thales again.